whistle all the while. If that's what it takes to make me smile, I'm gonna walk 100 miles.
So let's talk about this third pillar, which is profitability. And the difference between going into business and having a hobby is what? Making money. And what's the difference between having a nonprofit and having a business? It's making money. Now, I am not saying to you that making money is the be all and end all. It's not. But then let's call a spade and let's say you are just in it to have a hobby, which is, there's nothing wrong with that. You can have a side gig and you can have a side business. You're not really making any money. But if you say that you are in business or you have a business or you provide makeups, you know, you're a beautician or you provide personal styling or you're an organizer or you're even a freelancer with something like TaskRabbit. Well, guess what? That is effectively your business. Even if you're an Uber driver or Lyft driver, that's your business. So if you're in business, presumably you're doing it to make money. Now, I'm sure there are plenty of Lyft drivers out there who love to drive for Lyft, but loving something and not wanting to get paid for it are two totally different things. So if you go into business, let's say that you want to make money. You want to make money, what's that called? That's being profitable, because profitability comes after you've got your revenue and you subtract all your expenses, right? But see, I argue that I'm going to go back to these four types of expenses, A's, B's, C's, and D's. Cost of goods sold, time, productivity, and then D's being your overhead. Excuse me, C's being your forget-me-nots, all this little stuff that we forget. And so you have to set your business up in the very beginning to take into consideration those three things, your pricing and your productivity, because that's the only way it's going to lead to profitability. So I could make, let's say I got a new client who hired me for an event, and this happens all the time with event planners that I coach, and they'll say, okay, I got hired and the client paid me a retainer for $3,000 and I'm going to plan this event. Okay, great. Well, guess what? The average wedding to plan takes about 250 hours. So now you subtract all the expenses for planning that wedding. Even if you say, oh, I don't have any because like I'm just doing it myself. Well, by the way, you do, because you're going to have to tip the valet at the, you know, you're going to have to ship things. You're going to have, no matter what, there are always expenses. And so if the wedding, you know, let's say even if you had practically nothing in expense. You get $3,000, but it takes 250 hours to plan it, right? Let's say you only have $500 in expenses. So you're $2,500 you're bringing in 250 hours. Okay, you're at $10 an hour if you're lucky. And so many of us go into our businesses because we love it and we want to make people happy, and we would do it even if we didn't get paid. And I love that. But I just want you to know how much you're actually making, how much you're actually making per hour. Because when you know how much you're making per hour, I go back to that whole thing. Nothing wrong with making $10 an hour as a wedding planner. If you want to do that, knock yourself out. But if you aspire to make more, then you've got to have these three pillars in place, which is the pricing, the productivity, which will lead to profitability. And that's why I'm making these videos, is because those are the questions that I constantly get asked, is how do I price? I don't know. It's going to take me so much time. I don't know where to focus. I'm overwhelmed. Well, the reason that that happens is because there isn't a plan in place. So you really have to have a plan for all three pillars if you want your business to be successful and profitable. Pretty simple, right?
And if you haven't already, if you would please like this video, leave a comment if you're so inclined, but definitely subscribe to the channel so you can get more tips like this. Thanks.